Hello everyone. In school, you might have learned about order of operations in mathematics, where while evaluating a mathematical expression, we are supposed to perform the arithmetic operations in a certain order. First start with brackets or parentheses, then order or exponent, then division, multiplication, addition, and then subtraction. There are hundreds of videos available on the internet on how to apply this rule. So we don't want to repeat that in this video. Rather, we would see why to perform those operations in the order that you see here. There are several acronyms available for this order. The common acronym used for this in several countries is BODMAS, and in USA it is called PEMDAS. Between these two acronyms, the order of division and multiplication is reversed, but it doesn't affect the final result since these are inverse operations. Do you know why we have to follow this particular order? I didn't know for a long period of time. In your school textbook, you might have seen proofs of various theorems in mathematics, but certainly not this one. Why? Doesn't any proof exist for this? Or is there any holy book of mathematics that gave away these rules as a commandment? The whole idea of this video is to demystify the questions around this topic. Personally, I think order of operations rules has nothing to do with mathematics. It is more of a communication or writing system problem. We have thousands of languages in the world and hundreds of scripts exist to write them on the paper. Following is an excerpt from the Wikipedia page for the writing system. A writing system is a method of visually representing verbal communication based on a script and a set of rules regulating its use. Writing systems require shared understanding between writers and readers of the meaning behind the sets of characters that make up a script. Note that I have highlighted the words shared understanding because I think that is the basis of the BODMAS rule. Before connecting this idea to mathematics, let's first understand how encoding and decoding work, which is a fundamental part of the writing system. Though encoding and decoding sound like very heavy concepts, but they are very simple to understand. Let's imagine a world where there are two colleagues A and B who work in the same office but live on the two ends of the city. They sometimes have to visit different places in the city for their work. These places are not known in advance, and on a day when they have to visit a place, A informs B which place they are supposed to visit that day. There are no communication devices except this machine through which you can only send a stream of numbers across. For example, if there is this cafe 4 km to the north and 2 km to the east of their office, A can ask B to meet at that cafe by sending the distance from the office like this, 2040. There is already an understanding between these colleagues about how to interpret those numbers. B knows that these numbers correspond to the kilometer distance in east, west, north and south directions in that order. So when B receives a new message 0530, she knows that she has to travel 5 km to the west and 3 km to the north from the office. So the communication between A and B is clear and without any ambiguity. Now suppose there are two other colleagues C and D who also have the same number device but have a slightly different shared understanding of the order of the four directions. Maybe they have ordered the directions north, south, east, west. A message such as 3006 is interpreted as 3 km to the north and 6 km to the west by D when it comes from C. We can call this order of directions an encoding or decoding key. East, west, north and south is the encoding and decoding key between A and B, and north, south, east, west is the key between C and D. It is similar to two friends sharing duplicates of the same key to a storage locker. One friend can use this key to put a message inside the locker, and the other friend can use this own key to open the locker and read the message. But imagine what would happen if these two groups A, B, C, D start cross-communicating. If C sends a message to B, B would interpret message assuming her own order of directions and hence would reach to a wrong location. So it is important to note that for the correct communication, the encoding and decoding key has to be exactly the same. There could be even different ways to encode these directions. One of them is just using two numbers. The first number, if positive, means north, and negative means south. And the second number, if positive, means east, and negative means west. This way, 4 km to the south and 3 km to the west of the office could be encoded as -4, -3. This is what encoding and decoding are. Encoding is trying to fit larger information into a smaller message, and then decoding is trying to extract the original meaning back from the shorter message. I'm sure long back in history, when mathematical expressions were not invented, humans would have been communicating mathematical scenarios using long sentences with other humans, such as multiply 3 and 4, let's call it result 1, multiply 5 and 2 and call it result 2, now add result 1 and result 2 and find the final answer. But then there was some smart mathematician somewhere who thought, why not encode this long sentence into a short mathematical expression? There are different ways to encode this, using different encoding schemes or keys. BODMAS or PEMDAS is only one such key out of those many. But because it is accepted by the whole mathematical world as a preferred key, we can call it a standard or a convention. Let's take another non-mathematical example about conventions. We drive on the right side of the road in Canada, but when the first time roads were constructed, there was no law about which side of the road you should be driving. We had to make that law or rule or convention to avoid lots of frequent crashes on the road. Canada adopted right-hand side driving and Australia adopted left-hand side driving. And still, both the countries managed to keep the number of crashes on the road under control. How is that possible? Because if we decide one particular direction and then design the whole system around the same, then there is no problem. The problem arises when there is no concrete decision about things shared between multiple people. I hope till this point you have understood why we have BODMAS rule. But for fun and better understanding, let's find out if there could be a world where we don't have to follow any particular order of operations as a convention. I can imagine three different ways we can execute this. The first one is using sentences. If we are explicit about what operation should be done when, then the order of operations rule won't be necessary. For example, I can write a sentence, add 2 and 3, let's call it result 1, square this result 1 and call it result 2, multiply 5 and 2 and call it result 3, now add result 2 and result 3 and find the final answer. There won't be any ambiguity in this world since everything is so explicitly defined, but it is not a convenient world for sure. Note how long the sentence was, even if we have only a handful of numbers and operations here. Imagine if we try to translate long mathematical expressions into full sentences, then how complex this world would get. The second method is using just the brackets. In the second method, the same problem that we saw earlier could be described as follows, where we always use brackets to get rid of any ambiguity. The grouping with brackets makes it clear which operations could be done first and which can be performed only after all the inner brackets are solved. Let's see an example where the first maths expression, which we saw at the beginning of this video, is translated to this style of writing the expressions using brackets. The rule is simple. Always evaluate all the inner brackets before proceeding with the outer brackets. If you could follow one simple rule of completing one bracket at a time, there is no room for different interpretation in this one. In this third method, assuming there is no order of operations convention in the world, the writer specifically supplies her decoding key with the problem. Let's take a real-world situation and translate that to mathematics. For the writer's birthday, she is preparing a return gift package. each package would contain an $8 toy and a $5 book. She has to prepare 10 such packages. What would be the total cost of the written gifts? In an English statement, the mathematical problem would be add 8 and 5 and then multiply the result by 10. Following are the three different ways the same problem can be written in this method. All of these are correct ways to write the expression in this world, and the answer you get is exactly the same. But this is only because the decoding key is provided with the problem. If the decoding key is not provided, then everyone would follow their own order and there would be a chance of confusion. As you can see, all the three methods I described here are valid but inconvenient ways to encode a problem into a mathematical expression. That's why adopting one standard convention made sense to all mathematicians, and we have BODMAS or PEMDAS as our convention in this real world. If you found this video useful, then do like and share it. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more such informational videos. Thank you.